In this video, I wanted to share with you something I just learned about recently, and that is this app on Canva that helps you do text effects. It's called TypeCraft, and I'm going to show you how to do it. It makes stuff like this, so you can do all kinds of different text effects. I'm going to show you where to find it and how to use it, and maybe some of the limitations, because I think it can be even better than it is today. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to talk about something that I wish Canva had a long time ago, but it's good that they have it now, and that is text effects. So if any of you have used Canva, you know the only text effects that you can do right now is kind of warp it this way or work it up. That's it. You can bend it, really. But now there's an app on Canva that you can get to, built into Canva, and you can do all kinds of things. You can warp it all kinds of ways. I'll show you how to do it. I'll show you where to find it. I think everybody has it, not just Canva Pro, but you're gonna have to tell me because all I have is Canva Pro. So I'm gonna show you on Canva Pro what it does. So let's go to Canva right now and I'll show you where it is. So here we are on Canva, canva.com. You can see I've been playing around with it, testing it out. I'm gonna create a new design so I can show you how it works. So we're just gonna go custom size, 4,500 by 5,400, pull it up here. And the way to find it is to go to apps. So this right here, apps, and scroll down, and it's this one right here, TypeCraft. So click on that, and you can see right away it's pretty easy to figure out. So first thing you need to know is TypeCraft, this is where you type in the word that you want. So let's say I want to do something like California. Okay, and then these are the fonts you can use. So it's not every single font on Canva, which I wish it was. I wish it was every single font, but it's pretty limited for now. I'm guessing they're gonna add more fonts because, let me scroll down. You can see I can scroll down and see all of them. This is the full list. Mostly sans serif. There's not a lot of serif. In fact, I don't know if there's any serifs. There's some script ones in here. Oh, this one is a serif, but no thick serifs, slab serifs. I wish there were some slab serifs. There is a serif there. Some nice, cool ones right here, but I mean, come on, we gotta do some slab serif for some athletic ones, right? So, but you can see some italic ones, which I don't know why I would want italic when you can actually make it italic anyway. But anyway, you can see I'm using that font, Lethal, and it shows up here. And then these are the three styles for now. You have none, so just the fill, the black fill. You have outline, and you can see, or unfilled, which is just the outline. And you can see the border, or they call it border. You can make a black border, right? And then this one is outline, but filled. So you can change the color, the fill color to be like red, and then the border color to be like whatever color, pink or whatever, right? And then you can change the border width too. So that's kind of cool. And this kind of gives you a preview of what you're seeing. You're gonna see over here. And then you have all these points. So you can move any one of these points. So I can do this, something funky like this. I can also move these curves. So each one's individual, so I can go up this way and then down that way. So kind of make a funky turn like that if I want. Or I can do both of them up, you know, kind of like a bow tie, which is cool. Or I can make both of them kind of come down like this. I can do whatever I want. So one thing that I think a lot of us would do is maybe do something like this. So I'll come out here and, you know, do this curve like this, right? And then maybe make this curve like that, and this pull curve like this, and this one like that. So you can make that kind of shape. And if you like get too far down and like, I don't like this shape, you can always reset it and it just goes back to normal, right? In this case, see, I think they're still working on it. So I'm gonna change the font. And I guess I pulled it out too far. Whoa. Oh, there we go, reset. Whew, I thought we lost it there. Okay, yeah. So let's do that. Let's do the border. You see the outline, and let's just do a simple one so you can see. I'll do up like that and up like that, right? And maybe bigger over here than the other one. And then once you're ready and have it, you can add element to design, and there you go. And here you can scale it too. So if you need it bigger, you can. You can't do anything else but turn it. So if you want to edit this again, you'll have to hit edit. And even if you get out of here, so let's say I went back to design, I added some elements. Let's say I wanted to add this truck here or whatever and colored this. And then I'm like, oh wait, I don't want it to say California. I want it to say outdoors. I can come in here, hit edit, and it will bring me back into TypeCraft. So I don't have to worry about how do I edit this. You can edit it right here and say outdoors now. And once you see it here, you can hit update, and there you go, outdoors, right? Pretty cool. So one thing that we see a lot now is the vintage graphics, or the vintage type, and I wish they had some vintage fonts in here. I'll have to go and make a list and see if there is. I mean, we have Bauhaus, which isn't really that vintage. Let me do all caps, let's see. Vintage, right? So it's, I mean, it's kind of vintage, but it doesn't have that roundness that we see on some of the other ones. Let's see what else we got here. I wish there was a way to import fonts. Okay, so whoever's built TypeCraft, import fonts or add more fonts, I think is a good one. And I would love it if they also had some shapes that, like some basic shapes in here already. So we could do some like curved or warp or fisheye or any of those circle. I mean, some basic ones so we don't have to move this around all the time. If there was one that was like, it's already a circle, you know, like this, or it's already a curve like this, so we don't have to mess around with it. That would be really cool. But I mean, it's something. It's better than what we have, and it's definitely, there's a lot you can do with this. So play around with it, see what fonts you want. I may do another video just listing all these fonts so you can see them on the page. I may do that just because there's not too many, and I think it would be nice to see them all on screen to kind of see, because it's kind of hard to see like how good these fonts are at this small a size. Because this, I mean, there could be a good one in here, but it's just really hard to tell. This one isn't, I don't think this one is vintage enough. Let's see. I mean, I guess this one's kind of vintage. So we could do the, you know, the whole vintage curve thing that we see a lot, right? So we turn this up like this, and this comes up like that. Like that. And then this goes up like this. And we see this kind of thing a lot. Right, and then let's move this here. And then we do kind of that thing with the vintage. And then change the color. So of course you can come in here and then change it to like other colors, right? And maybe this one is a, I don't know, like an orange or something. Right, so you can do those kinds of things with this. So just have fun with it, play around with it. There's a lot you can do with these, and there's enough fonts here to kind of play with it. So I think it's good for now, but I think it can be even better. But yeah, it's just added a whole nother level of creativity on Canva, which I love. You can start making more and more things with this, and it's a great that we have it. It's better than what we have already, like I said. So there you go, that's TypeCraft on Canva. I think it's great that we have something like this. If you've been playing with it before, I don't know how long it's been out there, but if you've played with it before and there's something that I missed, let me know in the comments if there's something else that I didn't touch on that we can do with this tool. I think it's really cool. I think there's lots of different things that you can do with it, and I think it can really help with t-shirt design as well as other designs if you're not doing t-shirts. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see another video about Canva, I have lots of Canva videos, but this is my latest one here with some of the new things, new apps, not brand new now, but there's some cool stuff that Canva can do. You might want to watch that one. I highlight 5 different things that Canva can do. Keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.